this video, we're going to look at five things that you can do straight away to increase sales in the next 30 days. Hi, I'm Matt Elmer of the Elite Closing Academy. In this video, I want to cover five key things that I've noticed in particular over the last few weeks and months that I think you should be focusing on to get even better results over the next 30 days in your sales. Now, the first thing that I'm seeing a lot of is a lack from professional salespeople of sharing how it all works. So I think first and foremost, I think it's really, really important that you have got, for your product, for your service, real clarity around the promises, what it does for others inside you. You don't want to be explaining all this, because when you're explaining, you're losing. But you need to have certainty first and be able to share high-level information about how it all works. So that's really, really important. Next thing is, again, I'm hearing the opposite a lot. We have people come to our three-day training here, and one of the things I see in professional salespeople is the opposite of asking questions. And I believe great selling is asking powerful questions that are linked to what you do, both logically and emotionally. Listening, remember, listening is, it's actually an art, and also it's emotional to listen. So there's no logic in listening. It's actually really tiring as a salesperson to ask a great question that has a direction of travel that's obvious while you're asking it, that's got in great intention, but then the skill is to stop speaking and actually listen to what your prospects tell you. So the first thing you've got to do is share lots more information. The second thing you've got to do is ask lots of questions that have an outcome. Let me give you a quick example. A question like, so what's your biggest challenge in business, doesn't have any context, and it is of no real interest to anybody to answer that. There's no benefit to them. They're not sure why you're asking, and you've got to get the buyer's attention quickly in sales. So ask questions that are obvious, that lead to somewhere. So when it comes to sales, in particular closing, like, what if there was one thing that we could work on that got an even better result, what would it be? That's a powerful question. And you've got to have, I call that in my training, a PPQ, a prospect in pain question. You've got to grab people's attention really quickly. So the second thing in the five is to ask powerful questions that are linked to your outcome, not neutral questions, right? It's really important. Now the third thing is, why do we do this? Why do we ask questions and why do we listen? And the bottom line is, so that you can understand. Now, think about the salesperson that uses assumption or presumption to think they know what you're talking about or thinking. Think about that person, how annoying it is, because they've only got to say one thing that doesn't connect with how you feel and they're out. So like, the third thing you've got to do is be really, really, really committed to understanding and listening and asking. That's how you sell. Great selling is great questions with a commitment to understand and to listen, not to lead it, not to use language that brings no and yes questions into play, not to get them where you want to go so you get your commission, but it's being committed to understanding, and that's the third thing you can do. Refrain from telling people how it all works. Refrain from jumping into features and benefits. Let me tell you how it all works, bang, 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 bang. When you're explaining, you're losing. Think about that. When you're explaining how it works, you're losing. You want people to be asking you, so how does this work? And if we went with you, what about that? Like, that's what you need to happen. And that comes from questions and understanding. So have a commitment. I teach a system called PUNT with a Q. It's prospecting. The Q stands for quantitative measurable information. So when you're trying to understand somebody through asking and listening, you've got to be prepared to go where most salespeople won't, and that's towards the truth. Find out what really matters, what pains and challenges you solve, how urgent is it, what do they really need? Well, move towards that, and you start to become the solution to a problem rather than you having to shoehorn somebody down a route so that they understand how it all works. You want it the other way around. You want to understand them so that then you can bring the fourth thing into play, which is then to inform through sharing information that's helpful, that you've gathered whilst listening and understanding, is now to inform them of the options available to them. And that's critical. So you should have, like, I've got my desk here right now, I've got a written proposal, and it's high level. Here's how it works, bang, 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 bang. If somebody says to me, so Matt, I'm really interested, how does it work? I don't start talking. I say, thank you so much. Tell you what, let me ping this over to you while you're on. Ping, yeah, I've got it. Right, what questions have you got? That's how you sell. Rather than saying, here's what you get. Because unless you're asking, you're not understanding. And you might say something that isn't really of use to them. And if you're explaining, you lose it. So you have to explain how it all works. You're obviously not sending written proposals to people, which is critical. So the last thing is, now that you have followed these very four simple things so far, which is to share information. Human beings need information to decide. It's to ask lots and lots of questions that are obvious that they're linked to what you do, so that you can really, 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 really understand your prospect, so that then you can inform them of the options. And then the last thing, the fifth step, is for you, armed with all the information, and for your prospect to make a decision about what should happen next or not at all. And that's actually how you sell. Because once you've both decided that actually, from the information you've both been given, that you can both work together, collaborate together, they can invest in a product or service, so that you can both come out the other end even stronger, that's when it's time to stop selling and start closing. If you've enjoyed this video, then a couple of things you've got to do. Make sure you subscribe to the channel, and of course, ping the notification bell so you get your free training every single week. Check out all the other videos that are just up there somewhere.